Hi, sorry for that. Just a little pressure for time today. How's it going? How are you? Hi, Bidle, thanks for the follow. So, I wanted to talk today about Frogun Encore, because as you saw, it's been in a couple of showcases this weekend, and we have revealed the release date, which is... Hi, Mars. Well, Frogun Encore is coming out this month, by the end of the month, at day 25, and it's coming to all consoles digitally, and PC, on Steam, and etc. And I thought it would be cool if we started by watching the trailer together, because I'm really proud of how it turned out. Hi. Okay. So yeah, let's not wait for too long and get to it. What did you think? We are showing a little bit more of the late areas in the game, like in this castle and everything. I was a bit nervous about showing it because at this point we are so close to release, and I haven't shown anything about the late game areas, and I wanted to show them here. Hi, Ayase, my love. yeah, definitely, Crash Bandicoot 1 is a big inspiration for the fourth world in the game. You'll see a lot of spinning platforms and a lot of traps, and you climb around near a wall for a big part of it. So, today I wanted to do an AMA and get some questions, but things have been a bit calm. I don't have any questions from comments or anything. So if you want, what we can do is just continue with the stream normally and start modeling and talking about it. And you can leave any questions you have of Frogun Encore in the chat, and I'll take note of them so I can, after the model is done, answer them in order or something. Like, we could keep a few of them stashed, if that makes sense. That could be a good way to do it. Again, I'm a bit sorry about things going a bit slow, because it's really hard getting some traction in these days. Everything in the showcases of this day has been incredibly spectacular. I've seen a lot of games that I want to try when they come out. And I felt small compared to a lot of them, because they look awesome. Those games, those development teams, they really have put some interesting ideas to their best implementation. Okay, there's only at least a couple questions that I'll actually copy them on a notepad so I don't lose them. Probably not the most fancy way to do it, but yeah, it'll do. feel free to ask several questions if you have several of them, because at the end of the day, just having many things to talk about is already valuable. Okay, copying it up. Hi, Xpop. So let's just start modeling for now. Remember, you can ask any question about Frogun Encore in the chat, and I'll copy the message, and I'll go over all of the questions afterwards. We could have like a round of question answers. All right, setting it up. As you can see, I did a little bit of preparation in advance. I created as much as I got the preview file and added the reference, so we don't have to search for the files now. Starting a bit slow because I'm copying those questions. Wait a second. Here we go. A better view of the chat. Okay. So now I'm going to start modeling the next character. It's the second of four of them. As I said last time, there have been four friends that have helped me a lot with streaming, because I am a chronically shy person. I'm insecure, I'm a bit of a mess, and I have a hard time going out of my shell and talking to other people. And they have been really, really patient with me and have motivated me to try anyway. And I'm really happy that I did, even if I'm still a bit awkward when I talk here. But it's generally a good experience, I will say. I hope you are patient with me now. So, let's start modeling. This time, I think I'm going to start with a cylinder, because they are pretty useful for a few things. If you do this, and it's already roughly the shape we want. It's probably too small. I'm gonna make it a bit bigger and a bit higher. And now I can even extrude and merge to the center and get already a rough shape of the torso. I'm going to hide the little Norwegian one, because I want to use the Sonic model as a reference for size. This probably needs to be a bit bigger. Subdivided this one. Right. All right, just like that, we make everything round. Gonna make the center a bit thinner so it's a bit rounder. Getting some more questions. We've got 7 questions already, so that's a pretty good start, and we are so early in the stream already, so it's pretty good. Thank you, everyone. Now, since Shay's here, who I will talk about again because he's an amazing individual, he also streams from time to time and he covers a lot of different topics, plays a lot of retro games, and is in the business of developing adult games, which is something that you wouldn't believe because he's the most wholesome person in the world. I always will remember, like, for the first time when I met him, I was a bit like, oh, how's this? How's someone with works with adult content? And I was surprised at every time because he is like super friendly and always helps anyone who is in need. He's like a being of pure light. And eventually I learned that the people working in adult games are sometimes the most diverse and the most family-like groups of developers in the industry. I suppose that's not like a general norm. I suppose that's not true for every studio, but I only know him, so that's where my experience comes from. I've helped him with a couple of games, and I'm currently helping with a couple titles. And no, I am not making any adult content myself, but I am making models and code. Oh, couple more. Hey, that's already a bunch of new questions. Thank you, everyone. Oh, thank you, Ajase, for getting rid of the bot. You are quick, you are good at this. So now that we have the basic leg, I think it would be a good moment to remove the left part and to add the modifier. Now the shoes are going to be fun to make because they are pretty detailed here, and I will have to simplify a bit, but I want them to look as close to the ones in the reference as possible. So, big sock. Like this. I'm gonna get rid of the and needed faces too. I feel I shouldn't have merged those. I think it would be better if I just extrude it again and make it like this. Can become a triangle. Yeah, that's close enough. That could be bigger, as well as this. And I think this could go a little bit to the side too. Yeah, something like this. Something like this. Hey Apex. Sorry for being a bit slow on answering. I get sucked into Blender. Hey, Duper! Duper's here! Dancing! Like a madman! Sorry for being a bit slow with the chat. I get pretty absorbed when I'm modeling, and this time I had the good judgment of opening the chat in a different screen, which is just my drawing table pad. I'm still not looking at it. I'm not used to having a chat running alongside Blender. But I shall get there. All right. So now that I'm all set with the questions again, let's continue with the model. And it's pretty simple so far, but we're gonna do a couple cool things. Like for example, we could have the top a bit. Yeah, something like this. And we could even give it this little hill thing. Yeah. Note the back of the shoe has really weird topology. So we'll cut a couple extra lines to fix that. And with this we can fix the overall shape. Something like this, probably. Okay, we're gonna fix the little issue here. That's something that often happens to me when I'm using the mirror modifier. When something overlaps a bit, it gets stuck and you need to disable it for a second to get it back where it belongs. Oh, this one is, as I said before, this is Shades. He's a friend of mine, he's one of the few close friends that helped me set my streams and that is cheering me on whenever I try something. And I want to thank them all, that's why I'm making these little models. I made Little Norwegian last stream, who is the oldest friend I have in this circle. And next one is Shades. I've known him for a few years already, like I think 5 years or 6 years already. It's weird to think because it doesn't seem that long, but it is. I think his character is pretty cool, like with that punk jacket and everything. It's like a background character in the Sonic comics. It will fit right in. For the arm, I am just copying a leg section because since it's so simple, it just works. But I'm gonna modify it quite a bit. I want it to be a bit thicker than the usual Sonic arm because he's wearing a big jacket. And I think I'll actually make these big shoulders. And I'll do the same for the forearm. So it looks like there is some creases in it. Now let's see how it will look in this position. It's probably too long, so I'm gonna make it smaller. This is a very weird trick to check if your proportions are alright, but if it works, it works. Hey, thanks, Mark. Hi, Brand, too. Like, it's on fire today. How did I get? Everything's on fire here. I'm seeing all of the friends I've been making lately. I have to say it's a really weird feeling because I am not exactly a very social person. I can count my close friends with one hand. I'm not used to having so many people, cool people like my aunt around. I could get used to this. I really could do. Now for the hands. We are not making anything complex, even though the globes has got fingers. Sonic hands are just topsicles. So what I'm going to do is add a cat in it, so we have like the two different textures here. I think I'm gonna do it with textures, actually. Yeah, that's better. We don't need extra topology for that. Now, since he's wearing a jacket, what I'm going to do is take this a bit down. And here, I'm making a bubble. Same thing in the back. Actually, I'll get the look here. Because I'm gonna use that crease to create the jacket here. Like so. And I'm actually going to add a cat in here so this can go back to where it would be normally. Oops, sorry son. Alarms on my clock. Yeah, this is vaguely jacket shaped. Hey, the spirit resource is following me! That's amazing, because I use the spirit resource like every day for a lot of projects. Cannot recommend that web enough. Oh, thank you. It's okay, you can stay because I know you are probably the busiest person on Earth, controlling all of the sprites on the internet at once. Fun thing, I downloaded the Sonic R model from the modeler's resource, so there's that already, full circle. And then, this dream piece. I've been taken by surprise too. I think I'm gonna make this a bit smaller and go down. Yeah, something like this. And I think I'm gonna draw the other details in here rather than modeling them. I don't think Sonic R will have those as 3D objects. I'm gonna make this a bit rounder on the back. And I'm gonna make the tail host with Sonic. It's just a different mesh. I guess that works. I'm gonna duplicate a leg again. Everything is made of legs in this world. Alright, so what's the shape? It's a bit pointed up, so I'll also divide this. Like this. Alright. Much closer to what it looks in the reference. Oh yeah, Ape Escape music is amazing. It has that blend of electronic and regular video game music. And it feels always so fresh, so cool to have on the background. Oh, 90s rendering in Blender. Okay, that sounds fun. That sounds like something I would like to look up. If only I had more time, because lately I cannot keep up. I want to make so much stuff. I want to do so many things. And time flies. It flies like crazy. Something like this. Looks cool. Looks alright for the head. Yeah, something like this, a bit bigger. I'm gonna hide everything else and make it a bit squarer, a bit more like a block. And get rid of the left part of the screen. No, I think we can do something similar to what Sonic's model has here, which is, if we look, it's pretty simple, it's just a slant there for the middle of the face. It's just okay, we can get rid of those to get nice squares. And this just goes like this. You know, the same with the back, just to make things easier to see. And now this makes for the head shape. These two can probably be combined to the center. This should come a bit closer to this way, so it's a bit rounder. Render 96, I haven't heard that. I feel so ignorant sometimes. But I will look it up later, because that sounds interesting. No, it also should have a bigger gap here. something like this. Yeah, something like this seems more similar. And I can even make this go a bit to the side. Something like this. Topology got a little screwed, so I'm gonna correct it real quick. Just a lot of eyeballing, a lot of quick corrections. But you know, I thought it would be fun to work on them like this. Oh yeah. Yeah, something like this, and I can even probably put this a bit up. Yeah, that works. I can move this a bit down. That's closer to the original proportions. And this can go up. Now the nose is gonna be a different mesh too. Something similar to what the Sonic models do. One interesting thing about working with mirror modifiers is that you end up having more vertices than you need, because it could be really easy to just have a single triangle here in the center. But you cannot do that with a mirror modifier, else the triangle will be duplicated and it will look weird and fuck up the normals. It's a whole thing. Hey! Hi, little Drunkwija. Here I am, making the second one. George is here as well. It's gonna be a little cool collection. Now, how to translate all of those spikes to this little model? I'll start by making one here. That's like the central one. And now let's make another here. So this is a pretty simple one. Doesn't look much like the reference yet. But we'll get there. We just need to twist them a bit. And to add the little effects that we need. Yeah, something like this for now. And now these ones go down, so I'm gonna start from here. And now we have a face we can extrude for another spike. We'll go like this. This can go a bit up. This can go to the front. And I think probably I can get away with taking these two at once and just making this like this. No, we need a bit more volume. So probably these two. For another cool spike. Just like this. Let's see, 1 second. All right. Now let's make all of those spikes less strike, because they have some little curve to them. Especially this one has to curve more. I'm gonna hide Sonny for now, because he's always getting in the middle. Very fitting for his personality, because Sonic is a chronic protagonist, can get a bit on my nerves sometimes. This one, I think I'm just gonna cut like this. Yeah, I think that's a bit more like that. probably gonna add some volume like this. And now let's make the ears, because the middle tuft of the hair is a bit asymmetrical, so we are going to do it last. Let's see where are the ears with Sonic. They just come from here, so yeah, something like this should work. I think that should work for the shape. Now for the glasses, we'll just duplicate this. I'm actually not sure if... I think it probably doesn't. I think Sonic Air doesn't have any transparency. So we'll just have to model the glasses anyway. We're gonna simplify them a bit. This. Yeah, that works. Oh, Little Norwegian, sorry, I explained it before you came, but I'm gonna repeat again. This is Shades, he's another close friend of mine. I know him for like 5 or 6 years already. He's a really creative person. He also streams sometimes, has made some character streams, by the way, they were highly successful. He's helped a lot of different causes. He's like the most wholesome person you ever met that works in the adult industry. He works in adult games, and you cannot tell by simply talking with him, because he's like a little ray of sunshine. He's always helping everyone, he's always trying to make everyone have a nice time, and to make everyone be calm and chill with each other. In that regard, I have biggest thing for him, because that's a big skill, being able to not only work with a lot of people, but to make them all get along and work together without friction. That is really, really hard to do, and it's really valuable in the real world. And he's like the best at it, I have to say. Now let's just name the model, because right now it's just a cylinder. And actually, Little Norwegian is a steel cube here. So let's just go to texturing, I think. We're gonna duplicate this material because it's already set up, so it'll be easier. And here is Wait, I haven't got the texture ready yet. Hi, Sofeira! Really, I had to thank you everyone for being here, because when I started I thought that I will have like one or two persons in the stream at once, and I have been wrong since the beginning. It's always been a bunch of friends here, and I'm actually really happy about it. Because it's pretty easy to fall back to being a lonely person. It's very easy when you start feeling down to just think, maybe I'm bothering everyone, so I just won't say anything, I'll just stay on my lane and not bother other people. And at the end of the day, you figure that you wouldn't have bothered them, they don't mind. It's not just that I'm not a negative force of nature, it's just that I don't really matter that much on the global scale. Just existing will never be a bother to anyone, no matter the person, no matter who exists. And it's easy to forget that and having to remind it later. But I'm not popular. I am the opposite of popular. I am the lone kid in the playground who walks around at recess instead of playing ball or something. At least that's who it's been most of my life. I'm really thankful that lately I'm getting to meet a lot more of people. Again, I have to thank you all for being patient, because I know that I go around and around when I'm talking and I get lost in thought and probably sometimes bring out heavier topics than I intended. I'm sorry about that. Probably something I should get better at with talking more. Now for the texture here. We'll start with 64 by 64 squares. Let's see, here is a sprite. I got an empty texture, but I'll make little squares for the colors. Sonic Air has a really unique texturing style in which some faces are in some little islands with their texture completely stretched out, and others are just scrunched in a single pixel, so they are a certain color. So I'm just gonna open the reference image in a sprite so I can pick the colors. This one I should have done before stream. Let's see. There we go. So we are going to use this for the face. Actually, we are going to use an ever bigger one for the eyes, because it's what the original model does. I'm gonna open this one too, because that way I can see the shapes I've used before to make them consistent. I'm gonna actually pick this color too. And this one does have the uni eye, thing. So we're gonna use it like this. Good start for now, but it gets a bit weirder over here. Yeah. Something like this. Let's see how it fits here. I'm going to actually put everything together in a single pixel so it doesn't get too distracting. Pretty different from how the topology is in the original, so I'm gonna make it closer. Something like this. Actually, let me check. Yeah, that's pretty much it. Has a little triangle here to make everything smoother. Yeah, something like this. And now we have to make it fit this square, which is like backwards working as it goes for UV and grabbing, but that's how Sonic Air does. So I'm gonna do it as similar as possible. I think that's good enough for now, but I'm gonna tweak it here. Better. All right. I'm not using the plugin that connects Blender with Sprite. I used it for a while, but it broke, and I haven't gotten out to fix it again. I should probably uninstall it, download it again, and install it again. Because that was convenient, and I constantly forget to export to PNG. Also, I'd like to remind everyone that we are doing an AMA about Frogun Encore, and you can leave your questions now because I will copy them, and later we will go through them in order. And I thought it would be a really cool thing to do because Frogun Encore is coming real soon, and the release date has been published already. And I think it would be nice if we could chat a bit about that and get your doubts resolved. So feel free to type any question you have in the chat. Now let's see what size is this. By 20, okay, 10 by 20. Sonic car models don't have eye color, so I don't know if I should use this or make it black and just adding some brown shine on it. That probably works better with a classic style. That's how I did here. Something like this. Yeah, probably. What was it? Yeah. Something like this. Some little anti-aliasing. That's pretty close. We're gonna pick a light gray and add some anti-aliasing to the whole thing. It's actually in the reference. The eyes are half closed, so I'm gonna do that here too. Something like this. It's not exactly the same style as the one in game, because that one doesn't use pixel art at all. It uses full textures, even if they are pretty small. But I think that if you are going to work on a small enough texture, you are better off taking it as pixel art, because you just get a lot more control out of it. consult to availability like that. Perhaps even more. Yeah, something like this works better. Now let's see, because there is already a couple new questions. I should really learn how to be quicker with the chat. Oh yeah, my music list is all over the place right now because I decided to put it together for the streams. I had a separate list, which is also video game music, but I thought that it would be best to have a chiller one for the streams, because the one I usually listen to is the one I use for exercise or for running errands, and it's all rush and no wait. And if I'm already nervous whenever I have to stream and to talk with you all people, having that music in the background will probably make me explode or I'm breaking million little pieces, probably. We don't want that to happen, so. Now the eyes are a bit deformed, so let's tweak a bit the UVs. Yeah, something like this. Both the mouth and the nose and the shades are easy, because we'll just make a little square. And we'll just put the colors in here. And we'll use that. So now just like that, it already works a bit better. There is some bordering here that we could fix easily. We're taking this part and using this color instead. Yeah, I think that's better. No, we can do the same with the inside of the ears. And at this point we can start changing colors of a lot of things. Make the whole jacket the same dark color, but I think we will go and make a different color for it. We'll actually make a little cool trick here. So we can shade the transition between two materials. That's probably adding too much detail for what Sonic Cars usually has. So I won't do that. Something like this probably works better. So now I can take the whole side of the jacket. Just striking it up like crazy. Have something like this. So it has some little border in here. And we actually want to make a little subdivision here. Or maybe not, maybe here. So this can be this color too. Actually, something like this. This one can be the dark part, just like the inside. I'm gonna make this thicker so it gets a better view. You are making some really good questions. Like, it's gonna be so interesting now in a few minutes. I'm gonna get back to it. Some of those I hadn't thought about. So next thing we're going to do is probably adding another square here in the same color as the skin. I'm probably going to get this darker shade of peach. Yeah, gonna get it in here so we can use it in the model. Oh, this song is so good. I love Sam & Max because not only is like a good series of games and it's really fun and all of that, which is, you know, it's that's public knowledge. Everyone knows Sam & Max are cool. But also, that's how I actually learn English. As weird as that sounds, I was like mediocre at English because I didn't need to use it at all, and it was just another subject at school. And I wasn't very good at it, but then I got the episode 4 of Sam & Max, which was for free back in the day, like a little freebie, so you could get hooked on the rest of the series. And I love it. And I started talking like them for a little while, which was probably funny to anyone who heard me. But that's how I got more or less fluent in English. I think I had lost a bit of that flow when talking. I used to be quicker and to use more natural expressions. But you know, lots of years of only typing in English and reading it and never talking. So I'm still rusty. Now the hands are going to be easy to do. As always, it's just a little block. You know, sometimes texturing things can be a much simpler process than it looks. Sometimes the simplest unwrap is just enough. Sometimes you can just project from view and strap it to a square and adjust. And I think it's important to remember that sometimes you don't need to to overcomplicate stuff. If it works, that's enough. Nobody's gonna think that you are stupid because you made the simplest solution. In fact, it's probably the smartest thing to do. The socks. Shoes, we are going to simplify a bit because they have so much detail and I don't think that works well in Sonic R style. So we are going to simplify them a bit. It's gonna be just like a white trim at the bottom and the big square at the top. And the bottom of the shoes is gonna be the deep purple. Let's see. So something like this should work for most of the shoe. And then there is something like this. With a red border. Yeah, something like this. No. Something like this works. Something like this, so it doesn't clip. This one uses this. Sure, yeah, I forgot to change the thing and you've been missing on me moving little squares around. Now this one doesn't look as good as I want, so I'm gonna go back to the texture. I'm gonna include the white trim here. And also this top part. Now this look a little bit more like it should. And for the side, I'm just gonna pick those. And group them together. This should be white. And now for the bottom. Hi, Bloxit. Thanks for the follow. So now we are almost done with the model, but just need the little strand of hair. We are going to do it in a separate model, so we can keep the mirror modifier on this one for now. Something like this. It comes more or less from the center, but there's some interesting shapes. Something like this should do. This one is bigger and goes further to the back. It's pretty hard to do the same thing in which it goes behind the ear. But we'll try. Probably we'll need a lot of another loop. Yeah, something like this. Something like this. And finally we have a smaller one that goes here. And now all of this. Just becomes brown. And this one. We can probably get away with using the project from view. To get the center like this. So, what did you think? Probably looks a bit more detailed than the average Sonic R model, but you know, it's a more detailed model, it's a more detailed character. That's really a thing. I forgot a face here. Yeah, let's move this one to the correct place. Let's tweak the socks. Yeah, something like this. So, what do you think? I think it came out pretty well. Thank you. So now that I thank you, Nintendo Jam. Now that we are finished with this, I'm just gonna save for a bit so we don't lose any progress. I'm gonna make a little time lapses of these models. By the way, I've already got the first one halfway there, and I'm gonna upload those to YouTube and probably make even shorter versions for social media, to be honest. So if any of you just wanted the short experience, just the model going boo, just you can have that version of the video. Alright, so I'm gonna turn now the music for a second. I always end up at this song when I pause. I don't know why. So, it's been real fun working on this model, and we are halfway there with the series because there is two more to go. We have to make Duper and Gauntlet Queen, which are more recent friends of mine. I've known Duper for a while now, and more recently I've been talking with Gauntlet Queen, and they helped me a lot. Duper actually took on himself to be my extrovert master, so I can't thank him enough. So next stream we are going to work on his model. But now we got like 14 questions about Frogun Encore, so let's go over them in order. I'm actually going to do a little fun thing and... Yep. Real quiet. Alright, so we can have the trailer as the background as we go over this. So the first question is... Wait a second. Here we go. What would you say was the thing you wanted to improve upon the original the most? Well, I have actually improved on those things with Encore, because the original Frogun was a bit slow and was very puzzly when you move around, but as you move forward in the game and you go to the later levels, it becomes more challenging and it starts demanding the character to move faster and to do more tricks. So, for Encore, I decided to make the character run faster, jump higher, and shoot the Frogun further. And I think that is something I could do with the original Frogun if I made it now. Because as much as I wanted to make the moveset very restrictive, some people just don't have fun with that. And sometimes it's just not enough to move and to feel right. So even though in Frogun Encore you still need to shoot the Frogun around to move and to take all the shortcuts and to pull all the cool tricks, I made the characters move a bit faster, and I think that's what I will improve on the original Frogun. Of course, I will also do a lot of under the hood fixes to make loading faster and to have a better experience in general, but that's not something one can decide on. That's just the best you can do, and I hope that's enough. Now, next question is, did you consider making Encore as a DLC for Frogun in the beginning? And yes, that was the idea. But if I did that, the DLC would just be new levels, and with the old mechanics and with all of the problems that the original Frogun has. I didn't want that. I wanted it to be better. I wanted it to feel better. And I wanted to make different new systems and new stuff that maybe will clash with the original Frogun, like having co-op, which is simply something that wouldn't work with the camera and the original Frogun. So I decided to make it from the ground up, using the original Frogun's engine and tweaking it as necessary. And in the end, it's a similar but different experience, so that's not something that would work as DLC. Third question is, how much did Traitors Games Done Quick Run help with Frogun gaining traction? And I don't know. I cannot make for sure. I cannot make the numbers add up, because that's something really hard. What I would say is that Traitors Run was amazing from a moral standpoint and from a hype standpoint, because I enjoyed watching it. The escape into the big descent level, that was incredible. How everything was threaded to make it fit, how the character went through all of the kill planes in the just exact places. It was incredible. Next question is, did you want to make a sequel from the start? And the answer is no. I at first didn't consider it, but as I said before, some expansion to it was the original idea. I wanted to do that. It would be fun to add more stuff and to work it differently, but it wouldn't work very well as DLC. And I wanted to add a little spin to the characters, to make a small time skip, to show a slightly older Renata and Jake, and to make them be friends, like you are going to see them be at the end of the original game. So in this one, they are friends, they are equal adventurers, and they go together, and that's something I wanted to jump on. Next question is, since I learned about Frogun pretty late, how long was Encore being in development? And it's been in development for 2 years. It was originally going to be a shorter development cycle, only 1 year, because, you know, I'm using the design engine, I'm using everything that was made in the original game. That's a lot of things that you don't have to make from the scratch. But since it's also a bigger game in some aspects, even if it's shorter, it came with a lot of unique problems, because the levels are bigger because the character moves faster, but that means the levels are bigger files and that loading them is hard. So a lot of optimizations were needed. Also, since there is a lot of new moves, there were a lot of little things that would break that even if they worked before in the original game, could break with the new moves. Like double jumping could sometimes make the crumbling platforms fall earlier, and enemies could get stuck to you when you use that move. So in the end, a whole year of polishing and fixing and tweaking was added to the development cycle. And even though at the moment I hated the idea, I think it was for the best. Because even if there is always something to fix and something to improve, the Frogun Encore launch is going much cleaner than the original. I remember the original game having a lot of bugs at the beginning. People were finding all of the little ways to break it for good and for bad, because it wasn't all just fun tricks. It sometimes was soft locks or in general a worse experience. And I think Encore won't have as many junk. Next question here, and it's the sixth one, is, I remember in a podcast that you said multiplayer was troublesome. How did you go about adding in co-op into Encore? And is it local or an online or just local? It's just local gameplay, it's just local co-op, because online gameplay is really hard to work on unless you do it from the very start. You either model the whole engine on multiplayer or you don't. You cannot simply add online multiplayer after the fact because nothing works. So even though it's just local, I tried making the whole game focused on local co-op from the beginning. Changed the systems, made everything work from the start, and then anytime I added something, it would work on Couch Co-op because the foundation was the same. Next question we have is, of the two games, who's your favorite boss and why? And I gotta say, my favorite boss is the final boss in Frogun Encore. It gets the more exciting parts of every boss in every game, so you have to wait and see, but it's really fun. It will remind you of the final boss in Frogun Encore, but it will be different because the whole philosophy on boss fights in this game is different. Like, you don't have to wait till a specific moment to hit the boss once, and instead you have to hit him as many times as possible with the ammunition that you have at hand. And having to time your own attacks with the bosses, it makes it faster and more interesting. So yeah, it will be the final boss in Encore. Now for question number 8. Were there any levels that you escaped during development because you thought they were too hard? Or that they just didn't work how you wanted them to? No, that's not the case. Since I made the game almost on my own most of the time, there is this understanding of how the levels work, because it's just made by one person, so of course that person understands the levels. And so if they were too hard at some point, I just edit that part to make it easier. I've done that a lot of times, both on my own testing and with the help from Top Hat Studios, because that helped with quality assurance. And I could get some feedback. This level has this and this that is too hard, and this platform's timing is really hard to do, and I will modify it. That is something that I should have done with Frogun Encore, because with the original Frogun, I mean, because there were parts originally that were fairly unfair and required some precision platforming and some very quick camera twitching. And I modified some of those past releases, and that's not happening with Encore because we've already gone through that. Now, for question number 9, was there anything that you wanted to add to the original game that you hadn't been able to, but were able to get implemented for Encore? And yeah, that plenty of it, like grabbing on those swinging poles, and going to different parts of the world, having more complex bosses, moving coins, which is something very silly and very simple, but I didn't add to the original game. Those are things that I would have wanted Frogun to have, but that I thought of like later on development, and I couldn't add already without modifying the previous work. So I added them to Encore and made it a better game than it would be if it was just new levels. Now, next question is, what aspect of completion do you think people will have the most trouble with? I think in general, Frogun Encore is easier to complete than the original Frogun. Because you have better movesets, so there is more options for the time trials. And there is some features that can help you with completion, with coins and all that. So I don't think anything will be too hard in this one. Probably the coins are the biggest challenge, because you have to find all of them. But since this game has a fixed camera angle, they are not as hidden as in the first one. You have to go to some detours, you have to do some more extra platforming that you wouldn't need if you just want to ignore the coins, but in general it's not that brutal. Now, question 11. I noticed that one of the achievements in Encore is to beat all levels but has the same name and icon as the original for getting 100% Emblem completion. Is it later? Oh yeah, since getting everything in one level is relatively easy. Let me check, because I think... No, actually, yeah. Frogun Encore has an achievement for getting everything in a level, and another for getting everything in all levels. The latter one has a shinier icon with different color sets, but yeah, you have both. You have both achievements. It's fixed camera this time, because since the character moves faster and has better moveset. Tatal really makes the game deeper than the original Frogun in that sense. So even if having a fixed camera could simplify it and take from that depth, I think it's a good balance between the two, and it allows for multiplayer. So you can have two characters moving around at all times without the camera obscuring any of them. Though it still works for one character, and it doesn't make the game too dull, because there is some places in which the camera takes a different angle to get a better view of the platforming or a more dramatic effect, and you don't have control over it, it just happens automatically, but it still makes everything look nice and to feature the models from a different angle, so you can see the size of the houses and stuff like that. Now for another question. Is there any auto-aim or aim assist in Frogun Encore? And yes, the original Frogun game had auto-aim, but it's vastly improved here. It has a better angle, better distance judgment. There is items that can only be auto-aimed in certain occasions. Like for example, you cannot auto-aim a rock that you have to pick and throw if you already have something on your Frogun. You only auto-aim to pick them, but not to launch. That way, you can use that rock to hit other stuff without the auto-aim, just making you shoot a rock at another one and wasting two rocks that you could use to hurt a boss. There is also some painted targets on some walls, and those do nothing except grabbing the attention of the auto-aim. So in places where you need to absolutely hang to a wall, even though there is items nearby, I added those targets, so you could still accurately latch into the wall. So it's a lot of little things rather than a big change, but all of them together make auto-aim much better than in the original game. Now another question. If you had the ability to re-release Frogun, would you make any changes to it? And yeah, like technical changes, I will improve a lot of things. And probably I will also, as I said before, make her move a little faster. I will actually probably cut a few levels, not because they are bad or because I don't want them, but because the whole game became a bit long due to the Kickstarter stretch goals, and it can cause some fatigue. So I would probably delete like 6 levels out of it, just keep the best and change the theme if needed, just to make the whole game a bit more of a rounded package. And final question here. Can't you grapple onto the lily pads in Frogun? I haven't managed to do that yet. And the answer is no, you cannot grapple onto lily pads because they are flat and they are on water. And even if they had a high enough hitbox, you will need to be inside of the water to shoot at them. There is some parts in this game though in which the big lily pads have items on top of them, and you can auto-aim to them so to jump to the center of the lily pad, which is probably not exactly the same thing, but in practice it's pretty similar. So there we go, that's 14 questions about Frogun Encore. I think it's been fun, although I'm feeling it on my throat. And yeah, you can grapple to items. There's a lot of them actually for that. There's not only the swinging bars, but also flaging lamps and other things that only work as a temporary platform if you latch to them. There's also the bouncy mushrooms, the flying jars, If they are small items, you pick them. If they are big items, you latch on them and zipline to them. So that's a nice combination. Will there be a bundle for both games on Steam? Yeah, I think that's pretty safe to say. Because it only makes sense. Like, some people will just want both games, and getting them with probably a little discount will be pretty standard thing. So yeah, I'd say you can expect that to happen. Phew. It's been 2 hours already, and it's been so fast. I don't know why it happens, but when I'm streaming, time flies by, and by the end of the stream, I start feeling it. I start feeling that I've been talking for 2 hours, which is something I'm not made of. I'm not used to. But hey, what do you guys think? What do you, everyone, think? It was a chill stream, I think. Chiller than the previous two, probably, but in a good way. Thank you, Sofeira. I think I'll drink a lot of water now. I have a thermos here with fresh water, but I haven't drank the whole time because I forget that I have it here. So I will make good use of it now. And I'm really excited about releasing the game because it's been a long time. It's been a long development cycle, at least compared to what I was expecting at first. And seeing it go now is just like seeing it walk, like getting up and started walking. Thank you, Harald. I think it's about time to cut the stream for today, but I'm thinking about making another one later this week, on Wednesday. Make another one of those models, probably check some other stuff. I'm starting to get used to this, even if I still sound a bit awkward. So yeah, I'll make an announcement on my social media and on Discord. And I'll start another stream in a couple days. So I hope to see you all here again, because it's been really fun. And I have to thank you all for coming again, and for putting up with my awkward talking and weird accent and pronunciation. But for now, let's take a bit of time to rest. And let me see a thing for a second. Yeah. Okay. So yeah, let's say goodbye for today. As you get rid of this video, go back to your office. And take care, everyone. We'll talk again soon. Bye.